Hi guys, welcome to TechCombo's YouTube channel. Today I'm very happy. Why? Because I'm starting today my dream of presenting C programming tutorial. I feel my strength is C programming language. If we are so strong in C programming language, then we would be having the capacity to learn any programming language easily. If you look at here, I have presented 10 building blocks to represent C language. If you look at it, it is very simple. What I am saying is, you can easily represent the C programming language as like this: variables, data types, operators, control flow, functions, arrays, structure, file handling, pointers, and graphics. These are the 10 things which are more important in C programming language. If you look at this, the light blue color marked blocks are generally not applicable for other languages. But if you want to learn any other languages, the dark blue color marked building blocks are always the part of those languages. And that too, you will not find much difference. Only slight syntax difference would be there, but concept is same. But I'm pretty sure that what understanding we are getting through C programming languages, not surely you will get it through the other programming languages. Before we get into learning C programming language, we will see how it came into existence, how it came. There are two stories widely spoken by the people. We will see one by one. Poor performance of space travel game. When Ken Thompson and Dennis Ritchie were working at AT&T Bell Labs, they both were playing a game named Space Travel on mainframe system. If you look at the game, in space, you will have a spaceship and there will be multiple asteroids coming towards spaceship. If spaceship gets destroyed by the asteroids, then the game would be over. So the game is to escape from the asteroids and saving our spaceship. If you look at, while they were playing, they were not able to control the spaceship and it was frequently getting destroyed by the asteroids. So they thought to create a new game which is better in performance as well as supporting multiplayers. There was a machine, PDP-7, lying idle at Bell Labs, where they were working. So they decided to develop a new game on that machine. But the PDP-7 machine was not having any operating system in it. So they were thinking to write an operating system and started working on that. They have planned and developed the OS and game completely. They used assembly language to create the OS and the game in the PDP machine. By the time they completed the work, there is a new machine, PDP-11, arrived at Bell Labs. PDP-11 has good configuration compared to PDP-7. So they were thinking to port the changes into the new machine, PDP-11. But they were not able to port it easily and faced more difficulties. Because the instruction set of PDP-7, PDP-11 were completely different. On that moment, they were feeling that we should have some high-level programming language to easily port the changes into multiple machines with no difficulty. So they were decided to follow the B language. When they were trying to use the B language, they felt that B language was lagging on features and functionalities which they were looking for. So they were decided to create a new, better programming language. Since they followed B language, for their next language, they named it as a C. This is one story. Another story, what we were hearing is that if you see how Unix operating system came, was the thought process of creating asteroids game leads to the development of Unix operating system. They have completely written it in assembly language. They wanted to develop many utilities for the Unix operating system. While doing the changes, they faced a lot of difficulties in creating utilities. In that situation, they were thinking of creating a new language. Due to that, only C programming got developed. After realizing the C programming language flexibility and benefits, they completely reinvented the kernel of Unix system. That's it about the history. Why programming? To instruct a computer to do a certain task to be done. What it means is that instructing a computer to perform a specific task. For that, we are using programming language. Let's instruct a task. Task is sum of two numbers A and B, put the result in C and display C. Here the task is to sum the number A and B, post that, save the result into C and display C value into the screen. If you look at the task, we are instructing the computer through the C compiler. Present inside the computer, which is nothing but getting the help of a programming language. Now, what we are going to see is a programming way of approaching the things. That's what we are going to see in the coming slides. What is task? If you see, when programmers write programs, we see that as a task. How we are splitting the task, how the task is influencing to plan to complete the program. Now, for example, if you see this task, it has mainly two actions in it. What action? If you see, there is an action named sum and another action named display. An action requires input and most of the time it can have an output. Normally, if you see, what is an action? It requires input to perform a specific action or task. Like add these two numbers, perform a conversion from Celsius to Fahrenheit. Like these kind of tasks are considered as an actions. Sometimes we might require an output from the action. Like that, if you see, if your action is to find the length of a string, then you would require the length as an output. If we instead display string, then we do not require any output here. So, in such cases only, you would not require the output from the action. Now, what you are seeing here is an action which has an input and an output. Now, in our case, we have an action called sum. It has an input and an output. The input here is A and B, and the output is C. If you look at what C here is, the input to the next display action, which is a function. Nextly, output. There, exactly we are not looking for the output, but we are instructing computer to print the value C into the screen. We are expecting display function to do that. Now, even more elaborately, look at the sum function, sum action. This is one variable. If you look at the name of a variable is A. Its data type is integer, value is 10. Similarly, we have a variable named B. Data type is integer, value is 20. Nextly, if you look at in this action, we need to sum A and B. To sum, we are using the plus operator. The type of the operator is arithmetic. Since it is used for doing arithmetic operations, it's classified as arithmetic operator. Operation is addition. Nextly, we are using an equal to operator. We are using this equal to operator to store the results of addition of A and B variable. To store the result of an operation, we need an operator to store the data. The type of an operator is assignment. We call this operator as assignment operator. What it does is simply stores the value of the variable into a memory location of the variable present on its left hand side. This is the use of this assignment operator. Now we have used the variable C. In that, our result 10 plus 20, 30 got stored. If you look at there, just an action, sum, task requires variables, operators, and you have to differentiate the variables of its specific data type. Since we are dealing with integer, it has a data type as an integer. So like this, there are so many things we need to analyze. What are the things are required for an action? What are the variables are required? What are the operators are required? What other programming constructs are required? Like this, we need to analyze so many things. We have done this exercise to have such kind of analysis. Now, in action display, whatever we have already stored in the variable C is being sent to the function display. Here, display is an action. What it does is that it displays the value 30 into the screen. So now, if you look at this particular function, it has its own attributes like name, input is C, integer type. What operation is going to perform is display value, C value in monitor. It does not have any output. I mean, it doesn't return any data. It just performs an action, that's it. Now if you look at, easily you can understand that sum of two numbers A and B, put the result in C and display C. Action requires constructs like variable, operators, and variables of type integer. If you look at the operator, it has different operations like arithmetic and assignment. And we are using plus and equal to operator for that. So just for a small task, we could see that these many things are getting involved. So before going into programming, it is good to know what is variable, what is operator, what is data type. By this, what I wanted to say is, whatever programming task you take, you have to divide and see what are the things you require to achieve the task. Like what are the variables are required, what are the other programming constructs are required, etc. For that reason only, we have done this exercise. This is a journey of learning one programming language. As you know, we never start the journey completely knowing the roots of the entire journey. So, as part of this journey, I'm not going to completely go through each and every concept, but on the way, we will explore and learn the required things. Okay. In the next video, we will cover about variables in depth. Till then, thank you and see you again.